No woman has ever turned me on the way that girl does. You know, Dumebi is uncouth, semi-educated, unrefined, but she is the sexiest panther I've ever seen in the bedroom. My guy, I've learned a lesson, though. You know, when you see guys that, you know, handsome guys, rich and all that, hanging out with some women that are of lesser class, you know, women that are not even as pretty as you would have expected the wives of such guys to be. My guy, don't be amazed. You know, some guys that like hang onto their women as if their life depends on it. As if, you know, they can't do without such women, you know, following them everywhere. My God, only those guys know what they see in them. You know, only those guys know what is sweeting them. Sweeting them, in quotes. I am a living witness.
My brother. But seriously, I know what you're talking about. Did I tell you about my uncle?
No.
Like, my uncle is this short. He's one of the shortest people I've ever seen in this world.
As in everyone?
No, my uncle is not a dog, but he's short. Like, and he has this big pot belly, and to cry all he has a bald head. I swear to God. But go and ask his wife. She will tell you, leave and like that for me. I say, okay. Fine boy, no day for that thing. You know what I'm saying? She says, fine boy, not for body. Say, fine boy, without action, escort it be. You know what I'm saying? Escort, follow me, go party. Follow me, go wedding. Follow me, go bad day. But when she wants to be burnt, when she wants to be torpedoed, she knows where to go to, my uncle. So she says she'd rather spend the rest of her days with this man who would rather spend every hour of his in the bedroom trying to please her every whim. It's amazing, but seriously, I know what you're talking about. I'm not a stranger to it. I live with it. My uncle is one of them.
You know what? Only her knows what is sweeping her.
Oh, sweeping her there. Absolutely. You follow me?
Oh my God.
Oh my God. Against me.
So, you know what? Man, I still have not seen the right word to describe this drug to me.
And what is that word?
That's the problem, man. I can't find one word.
You know, Frank, that really seems like a big problem for you. Seriously, like a big emotional problem. What you gonna do to Cynthia when she comes back? I mean, Cynthia, your girlfriend, the one we all know. What are you going to do when she comes back from the States?
I don't know. That's the question first. Honestly, so, I don't know.
You're going to send Dumebi away?
Sweet mango Dumebi. Never.
Never. Never.
Why? Cynthia will go.
With all her polish, poise, class, and exposure.
No.
My guy, let us say that what I have now is an impasse of the heart. Honestly.
Impasse of the heart. That sounds like a movie title.
You know, this is just an impasse of the heart. You know?
Don't tell me you're back.
Hello, darling. Are you surprised?
Very surprised. So, when did you get into this country?
This morning. I slept all day knowing you wouldn't be back from work till this evening. As a matter of fact, I am on my way to your house. Are you home? We need to catch up. I missed you. I missed you so much.
No. Work. Later.
You're not at home. You're at work and you call me later.
Exactly.
Alright, baby. See you later. Mwah. That?
I thought you were not listening. And you said, who was that? Not who is that?
I used to listen with my ear, not my eye. Who was that?
My friend.
She don't like to speak good English. I used to compare my English with.
You don't even know for sure. She's a girl. So why did you say she?
Frank, you now will not allow you to carry another woman to this house. Because I know my rights. My father is a captive. He read plenty book. And he tell me my rights before I come here. So, I'll not allow you to carry another woman to this house.
Nobody's talking about bringing another woman here.
Guy's not at home.
Move aside, let me pass. Oga?
Ondi.
What is wrong with you? Listen, your Oga has been avoiding me since yesterday and I don't know why. This is still early morning and I know he has not gone to work. So will you let me pass? Oh, you want to fight with a woman this morning, eh? Because if you dare as much as ruffle this dress I'm wearing, I'm going to lock you up.
And listen, it's not my fault now. Oga Frank, they fear to see you. And he's confused right now.
Why?
I don't know. I don't understand. I beg, wait. Please. If you go inside, I beg. Tell Ogana you're the person that forced me out of the gate. Please, or I beg you, or you force me out of
no one my job. Nobody will start.
America for just 2 months. and I come back to see you comfortably asleep in the arms of another woman. Please do what, Frank?
Baby, I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
So this is the reason you avoided me yesterday?
It's not that bad.
Because she's here. Frank. Frank, whose baby is this? Frank, is this your baby?
Yes. I'm sorry.
How? When did all this happen? How did it happen?
Last year. During my leave in the village. I met this girl. And I went to the village. To maybe meet Cynthia, my fiancée. Cynthia, meet to maybe. Her father has actually been forcing her on you.
You said you love me. Like I do not allow you to not be happy in this world and you die.
Send her away. Send her away and I'll forgive you everything. I will not even ask you for details.
Cynthia, I would have loved to. But I can't. I just can't send my blood away.
Alright then. I'll leave you. Enjoy your village, girl.
Cynthia, look, I can send her to the boys' quarters. And she will live there. She will never be on her way. She will eat and raise the boy there. And when the boy is grown, I'll send her out, never to come back. You and I have come a long way in this relationship. We've invested a lot to allow an item of lust to come between us.
I'm not an item. I'm an item.
Where are you going? We still need some bushmeat to service my man around here. Come back! Sidekick! ABC! ABC! Come and get her things out of my man's room now. Out all those things from there.
Mm-hmm.
Fast. Pack everything out. Sorry to send you this kind of errand,
but
I know they are smelly. When you finish, you wash your hand, eh?
Whatever, finish packing
it. No, you're done. Wash this shit, so. Okay. Oh, come on from there!
Mm?
What is wrong with you? You want to use the same hands using touching those smelling dirty things to touch this wall and contaminate it?
Mm-hmm.
Please just take these things out. When you go, you have your bath. Make sure you shower before you enter this house again.
Thank you. I'm sorry that things worked out this way, okay? You see that lady? She has 2 master's degrees from the university. And I'm sorry, I know you don't know what that means. But I cannot take you out when I'm hanging out with my friends. You will disgrace me there. At times like this, she's the one I can hang out with. Okay, if my bank is doing end of year party, I cannot take you there because you don't know table etiquette. You don't know how to eat with fork and knife. And I'm sure that even if I take you there, if you break glass cups, you will shout, "Okonkwo, no!" Before I even know anything.
Please, I don't want any trouble. Take me to the quarter, let me put my things there. I don't want any trouble.
But, having said that, you will be well taken care of. You and my son. Look, things are not as bad as you think. I want you to look at the bright side of things.
I could have rejected you and my son and passed you back to the village. But I didn't do it. I accepted you
and my son and accommodated you in my house. Who knows? One day you might become polished and I'll take you out too.
I don't want. Please, I don't want. Because I don't know the English, I'll speak now. You say I'm bush. I don't know how to speak English. I don't want trouble. Take me to the court and let me go and sleep. I'm tired.
My God.
Let me give her some money for her needs.
How are you? Fine.
Oh! If you want to talk to me, talk to me. I don't know why I look at my breast. So.
Then shut up. Lower your voice.
You lower your voice.
I'm here to give you some money, okay? For your needs. I don't know what you need, but I want you to have some money in your pocket. Clean out.
Do you love her?
What?
Yes. Because you call me Sweet Mango Dumebi. Is she Sweet Mango Cynthia? I know she's not sweet. I know. I know, I think I don't know. I know.
What nonsense are you talking about?
Frank! How long does it take to give someone money?
I'm done. He's already coming.
I'm not leaving this house. Oh. I will not leave this house. This is my son's father's house. I'm not going to go. I'll be here.
Mom, what are you doing here? What are you doing here? What happened to Bitter Leaf Cynthia?
Why do you call her that?
Bitter Leaf Cynthia. If she's not Bitter Leaf Cynthia, then what are you doing here? Is it not because she's bitter and I'm sweet? Is that not why you're here?
Yeah, anything you like, say. Yeah, I want you to touch me.
Don't you, you see?
The one that puts on the generator. What are they busy? Is that not his job?
I don't understand that boy again. Nepa took light and he refused to wake up.
Nepa took light? But we're on Nepa light now. Is this not Nepa light?
No. Just as I was about to put on the generator, Nepa brought back light. So I had to top off for coming inside. That's what I'm trying to say.
Frank. Frank, where are you coming from?
I'm going to put on the generator now. Will I be lying to you? Okay, where else do you think I'm coming from?
Okay, come to bed. I want to make love.
Oh, why not? All right.
Sleep! There's no breath again. Breath is skinny. She's dry. You have eaten everything. My eye is telling me too. I'm angry. Alice! Let me go look for food in the main house. There's no food. Cannot talk any best again. There's no best again. Ah! Me along with you now. No, it's anything. Say cry. My love, do it.
A mad woman.
Yes.
How did she enter the compound?
I was just pulling plantain and I looked at the window and saw a mad woman standing.
So, what was a busy doing at the gate that a mad woman would pass and he didn't see her?
I don't know, Frank.
Come and show me.
Are you coming like this? You need to come with a cane or something.
Did you see any mad woman here?
Mad woman?
Yes.
Where?
Where is the mad woman you say you saw?
I thought she was the mad woman.
You need to see the way she appeared at my kitchen. I was scared now.
Me?
You thought she was a mad woman. How?
See her now. Look at what she's wearing. Look at her face. Look at her hair. What's the difference between she and all those mad women we see on the streets? Me, I was scared though. I panicked. I had to come and call you. Hey! So this time I'm going to be suffering in my son's father's house? I only came to check if food is ready. You not suck breast yesterday night. You want to suck breast now again? My eye is turning me. I cannot have power to give him breast unless I eat. I came to see if food is ready and I'm not a mad woman. My dear, go to the mirror and look at yourself before you talk. Look at yourself from head to toe. If you do not see a mad woman, if you do not see a woman who has gone loco, come and shit on my pillow. You see? You see? Your sweet mango Dumebi has become a mad woman. After she has called me stupid girl.
But why do you even dress like this? Look at the way you're tying up on your shoulder. You've not even taken your bath and you're looking for food.
Oh, you want to support her?
I didn't say so.
You want to support her?
I didn't say so.
Just warn her. Tell her. On no account of anything I do, shall she call me a madman. On no account of all.
You see? You started speaking wrong grammar again.
Okay. Go with her. Go with her. And when night come, make sure you sleep with her English. Because if you come to my room, I will shout. And she will know what to do every night.
Shut up. Are you so loud? Shut up your mouth.
Oh God. Oh my living God!
But I see the sir should give you this food. She said I swear that it's enough for you and your
maid.
Huh?
Let me back.
Huh?
Let
W has grown meal thick and now she wants to bite me. But you know me now. I do not have time to dance in the rain with little children that cannot ditch their private part. No problem. No trouble. She can reject my food. But what I will not do again in this world is to cook and send to her. She either starves in this house or she opens her own kitchen in that girl's quarter. Are you ready? I'm going to work. How old is that baby of herself? When is he going to grow so she can leave this house? I don't even blame her. It's you I blame. I don't know why men of these days cannot see a shaking ass and look the other way.
Calm down. You're working up a temper.
Let me work up a temper.
You're going to be in bad mood to face work today.
It does not matter. It doesn't matter. Why is she even claiming rights in this house? Is it because she has a baby for you? Like I cannot get pregnant and have a baby for you too? Frank. Minus the challenges of my job, I would have had a baby for you long before she drops on the horizon. Anybody can get pregnant and have a child. There is no big deal in it. People should just stop blocking my eardrums with Junior this, Junior this. I will not hear anything in this house again because maybe gave birth to Junior. Junior what, Seth? Junior Frank? It better not be you. It better not be because my young baby will bear Junior Frank and not the baby of a smelling bushfowl. Not a little dog blues baby. Have you heard that? I'll see you later.
Dumebi. Dumebi.
Good afternoon.
So, how is the baby today?
Fine, sleeping.
Oh, I'm fine. I'm on lunch break from the office. So, I came to give him money, you know, cream and baby food. Now, take it. This is 20,000 naira. I don't want you to lack anything.
Thank you.
Cynthia has come to work now. So let's go to the main house. I need you so much.
Let me alone. Go to Cynthia.
Look, Cynthia is just beautiful, elegant and polished, but she's dry. You're the one that arouses the man in me.
But she says I'm stupid. Everybody says I'm stupid.
Don't mind her. You're not stupid. Intelligent. Okay, if you don't want us to do it in the main house, okay? Let's go and do it.
No. We'll do it in the main house. In the bedroom. On that bed. It's my right. If you don't want to do it there, then get away.
Anything you say now. Huh? Sit, mango. Anything you say.
What you are doing, is it good? What you are doing, is it good? You are living in the main building with her. Me, I'm living in the backyard, like a slave. Your son is living like a slave in his father's house. Is it good? Anyway, I want to give me money. Let me go to the market and bought stove and many, many things. I'm cooking by myself here. I don't eat Cynthia food anymore. The way my son grow, I'll tell my son to beat her. I don't eat her food again.
Hey, don't talk like that.
I'll talk what I want to talk. See, I'm no longer afraid. I've seen plenty of things in this my life. I've seen something. I've suffered. I'm not going to be here and be eating the small, small food that Cynthia is giving me. No. If my son will not grow now. My son will not grow. Follow me.
Of course. You know I'll follow you now. See you.
Bleaching body. Bleaching body? That girl is bleaching. Be naive. She's bleaching.
Stop that. Just lie down and remove your clothes. I mean, don't worry. My lunch break is just for 1 hour. I just want to do and rush back to the office.
If I call you, say ma, or I'll remove my clothes. Say ma, oh. Dumebi is now knowing something. Dumebi is no longer foolish girl. Frank!
Come. Please. Stop this kind of thing. I told you I'm in a hurry. Just remove your clothes. Lie down and spread your legs. Hurry. Move your move.
Okay, I take my left.
Come.
Frank!
Ma.
Frank! Oh no, no, do my baby bush power!
Ma.
What is the problem?
Nothing. You know, you always come back home with work from the office. It gets boring for me. Sitting here alone, watching you work. Not talking to anybody.
You don't want me to work? You'd prefer if I was a lazy bum?
Of course I want you to work. But I also want to share my day with you sometimes. You know? Like gist and all that. We sit here as if we are in a no-talking zone. All evening. Then we go to bed. And you sleep off before your head hits the pillow.
My dear, such is life. I am a career woman, just as you are a career man. But you have me weekends, don't you?
So if I have something light to share with you, maybe something that happened in the office, you know, some hot gist, you know, to share with you, I will keep it in my mouth and wait till weekend, huh?
Every career woman owes herself a duty not to let the man in her life put her in a box. Men like to have control, and they get naturally uncomfortable when they do not have that total control over the women in their lives. You are not an exception. But am I going to let that affect the job I have to do? My answer is no.
You know what?
What? Let me finish.
No, let me just say that.
Let me finish! When I finish, you can say whatever you want to say.
That's the problem. You don't ever let any other person talk. You're the wisest woman on earth. Other people's opinions do not count. That's it.
I should now allow you to talk so you can make useless points. I am no pushover. I am educated. Well educated for that matter. I earn a salary for the job I do. A job I do very well. I am not a woman kept in the house and catered for by any man. I pay my bills. I fend for myself. And I am with you because I want to be with you. You understand that? So, whenever we argue, you must also give me the room to make my own point.
So, who hasn't given the other person room now? Me or you? No. Who has been talking sense? At times, it's good for the woman to keep quiet and listen. Even when the man is talking nonsense, let her keep quiet and make her points later. It's good for her to make the man feel like a man sometimes. Make him feel as if he's winning the argument. No man wants to be with a woman who challenges his points every step of the way. Reserve that for the office. This is a home, for Christ's sake.
Whatever. Enough of this distraction. If you want a dondi, a dance, you know where to go now. Not far from you, the boys' quarters.
I don't want a dance. I just want a woman that makes me feel like a man. A woman who, even if she knows more than I do, she would talk to me in a manner that will not make me feel inferior.
Ego. Ego will not kill men of this world. Listen, can I walk now? Enough of this distraction, please.
Okay. Good night, then. Meet me in bed when you're down.
Good night, darling.
The old man rejected his balance, insisting that he has 1,000,000 naira in that account. So why should we give him 300,000 naira as balance? We were thinking of that day. This is what happened in the office today. So that day, today, he came with his son to withdraw 100,000 naira. Sign your signature now. His hand, shake. They informed me as the bank manager. So I now told the old man, why can't you get a signature to the account? You know what signature means? It means a person that can sign and withdraw money on behalf of the owner of the account. Mm-hmm. So the old man said, okay. He wrote a letter. They brought the letter. Signed the letter now. Problem. He wanted to sign the letter. So the grandson was like, hey, I can help my father and sign the signature now. I said, how are you sure you can get the signature? He said, because I've been using it now to withdraw money from the account. I signed the signature and withdraw. And the crook that has been withdrawing money, we arrested him there and then.
Don't catch him. Don't just catch him like that.
See mango. See mango. See mango, baby. You're fine these days.
Go.
Let me go and change my.
Do you want to go now? Do you want to go so that Peter leaves Cynthia will not come here and catch you laughing with us?
No, now. This is my office dress. I want to change now too so I can be free. You know? To wear normal dress now.
Talk about the money for stove and food stuff.
Okay, I'll send it to you later in the night, eh? Or tomorrow's morning. Tomorrow is Saturday now, so you can go to the market tomorrow.
Okay.
Eh?
Okay. Hmm? Go. Go. I'll catch it. Go.
I'll catch you.
Go, girl.
Now leave this house at once. Leave!
Why should I leave? Why should I leave? Who are you? Who are you? Think you're better than me. Because you went to your university. Let's fight now!
Let's fight now! Let's fight! Let's fight!
Oh my god! You are so hilarious! What in the devil's name is university?
Do as she said and go to the boys' quarters. I'll send a BC to get you whatever it is you need. Here is not meant for you, okay?
That's what I'm going to say. That's what I'm going to say. You're going to say that wicked word to me just to please Abby.
Shut up and do as I say.
You need to close your mouth. Close your mouth too. Let me talk. Let me talk to you. I know you can't speak English in your world. I know you know your English in your world. Is it my fault? Is it my fault that I pep Jesus one 6 times? Eh? Let me tell you. That's the level I get to before the books are like of using my brain. If you don't know, ask anybody. That's what I will tell you. What do you mean? Eh? Why are you laughing at me? Why are you laughing at me? Why are you making fun of me? Eh? When she's not there, you come. Lunch break. 1 hour. 1 hour. Only 1 hour. You not let me rest until you sleep with me. But when she's there, you behave as if I'm smelling. You took a damn sense. You took a damn sense. I'm not going to take my child and I'm not going to leave your house. If you don't have any letters to sleep, we'll be on the road!
Stop.
Wicked man!
Come. She's talking. Come. I think she's angry.
Hey! Just hold it there. You know what? I'm leaving you too. Because you're such a confused man. You don't even know what you want. Call me when you decide who you want to be with. Polished Cynthia or dirty, smelling, bush, stupid Dumebi. I'll get my back.
Her clothes are old, but she has a beautiful smile. She really can act so strange. I know she will never change. So maybe she means the world to me. Ordinary girl in an ordinary world. She's not a sophisticated lady. She's not no big drama. She's so
Hello. Where are you going to? Can I give you a ride? Well, you shouldn't be on the road with your baby like this. Huh? We'll give you a ride.
you are going.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
Don't tell me sorry. Don't have an accident though. Somebody's house.
What? Who? Whose house, Dumebi?
It's the man that helped us yesterday. I was carrying Junior, went across the road. I was almost crying. The man that brought us to his house and gave us a place to sleep. Now I'm drinking juice.
Oh my God. You're in a stranger's house. What if he rapes you? Are you stupid or what? Leave that house and come back now as I'm talking.
Don't command me. Don't command me.
Huh? I will command you all I want. You're my wife!
I'm not your wife. I live in my dowry. My bride price. I left your house since yesterday night. See the time you're calling me. This morning.
Shut up! Is that what you're talking? Is that what you're saying? You know what? Go to hell. Don't even come back. Look, if I see you in my house again, I will push you out.
Nonsense.
I hope all is well. I heard you yelling on the phone.
All is well.
Oh good. Okay.
Can you drop us at home now?
Okay. Let's go.
Thank you.
But you give me your number, then I will give you my own. Okay. Let's go. You join me in the city.
Yes.
Okay.
Cynthia, you've always been my love. Darling, please forgive me. You know, I'm a man now. The temptation was just too much for me. Please, please, please. I beg you, come back. Come back. Yeah, I promise to be a better man. Yeah.
Please, I'm surprised.
God. Look, I promise I will never do such a thing again.
You promise?
I swear.
Hey! Hey! After you've come to beg me, I've come back now and I'm still with her. She's still here. Frank, what is the meaning of this rubbish? So you haven't put a stop to this? You brought me here to embarrass me? You have to put a stop to this rubbish that is going now. You have to put a stop to it. I'm going back to that man's house, that man that buy me juice. I'm going back there. When you decide who you want to marry out of the educated girl and the foolish village girl, call my number. Don't touch my box, sir. Don't touch my box.
You cannot go back to the man that you don't know. And you? What are you doing here? What are you doing? My friend, talk it out. My beautiful, beautiful woman. You see, the last time you were here, I didn't give you money. And that's not good enough. So, here, just 100,000 naira to put in your purse. Mm-hmm. Here, you see this money? I'm giving you from the bottom of my heart. No strings. You know, and that's because you deserve the best from any man. Come on, take it.
Me?
Yes, you. Who else are we talking about? It's not just the two of us in this house. I couldn't have been talking of someone else. It's you, of course. But come on, take it. Mm-hmm. You're welcome. You're welcome. Huh? You see, your beauty intoxicates me. And like I always say, you know, there'd be anything you think I can do for you to make your stay perfectly wonderful, fantastic. I will do it. Just say it, and I will do it. Okay? Yes, let me sort out the visitor's room again. Okay? Or you want to sleep in my room this time?
No, I'll sleep in the best room where baby is.
Okay. It's okay. Just 1 second. Huh? 1 second. Very beautiful. 1 second. Oh, fine, beautiful girl.
Why do men do everything I want them to do? Why did you look at me like that? I'm not easy to get. I don't know how to speak English. I don't even know how to use fucking knife. Why did you look at me like that? Even Papa in the village. Papa used to call me foolish Dumebi. Everybody in the village used to call me stupid Dumebi. But in this city, all the guys I've seen want to be with me. Even though I have Junior. It means that I have power over them. Hey! Hey! They want my body! They want my body! Hey! Bad men! It means that there's power in my body. There's power in the body of a foolish village girl.
to control all the city men. They want my body. Now that I have discovered that they want my body, hey, and not how to. These men, they have allowed me to know something I did not supposed to know. They allowed me to know something I did not supposed to know. Hey, bad men, bad men. No, no. All of them bad men. Bad, bad men. Bad men. I should sit. I should sit. I see their eye. Their eyes like thief. All of them is sitting. Their eyes like thief. What the eye? They're looking at me. My gosh. Not how to. Now that all of them want my body, I'm going to buy a new car. I'll buy a new car and take it to the village. Papa, I'm not more stupid. I'm more foolish. I'm smart, Dumebi. Wise, Dumebi. Access. All of them, thief. City men, thief. Thief. Hey. Dumebi, the foolish girl. I've become Dumebi, the smart girl.
Dumebi. Yeah, please come back home now. It's been 2 days now since you left home. Yeah? Come back home, or at least tell me where you are.
If I tell you where I am, what are you going to do? Are you going to come here and force me on your head and take me home? Or are you going to tie me rope and take me to your house?
No, no, no. Eh? I will at least come to you and beg you for forgiveness. Eh? And convince you to return home. This is your home now. Sweet mango, do maybe. Akwa gazem. Tell me, where are you?
I don't know where I am.
Okay. That man that is harboring you, is he there with you?
He's not here. He has gone to business.
Dumsum. Sweet mango. Tell me now, where are you?
Let me down get the gate man phone, let the gate man tell you where it is.
I'll be waiting, eh?
No small place, so it's deep. Maybe it's a boy quarter. Wait!
Good, maybe.
So, this is where you stay, eh?
Yes.
Where's Junior?
He's sleeping in the house. The main house, so. Not the boys' quarters. We have our own room in the main house. We are staying in a good house. The owner is a good man. He never touched me. He's been so good to me. He said if I want to marry him, he will pay my bride price today to day.
God forbid. Pay whose bride price? Is that possible?
You're already married. Since I've been in your house, have you asked me if you can take one bottle of whiskey and go and pay my father for bad price on my head? Have you asked me? Because you get me for free. You play me like football. You play me to the backyard of your house. Eh? I'm not more stupid than you. I'm now wise. I'm not your wife.
So who taught you all this? That man?
His name is not that man. His name is Mr. Jim. He did not teach me anything. No. I learned something by thinking to myself when I was in your boys' quarters with my son suffering. You are being inside AC, enjoying with Bitter Leaf Cynthia.
Okay, now that Bitter Leaf Cynthia is gone, just go inside and collect all your things. Let's go home.
I cannot. I'll wait until Mr. Jim come back. You want me to pay good thing with bad thing? No, I have to wait for Mr. Jim to come back. I'll tell him. If he says I should follow you, then I'll follow you.
Meaning that you need his permission to
to return to me.
Yes, because I tell him everything that you have done to me. I tell him, he's very angry. Mr. Jimson, you are taking advantages of me. Yes, advantages. You are taking advantages of me. That's what you are doing. And he's saying I should not allow somebody to treat me like a nobody. Because I am a somebody. A very beautiful somebody. A somebody that will take my rightful position in a home. Yes. That's what he said to me. Mr. Jim, I've opened my eye. And my eyes. My eye open.
See, I will carry you now. And I swear, by weekend, I will take you to the village and carry out the marriage introduction between you and I.
What? What? Why me? Why me? Oh, so you cannot take me to your company and a beer party. You can take bitter leaves, Cynthia.
To maybe sweet potato. I have employed a private teacher to teach you. And I know you will learn because you're smart. That's because I love you. You're the one I truly love. I want to be with, eh? That one is for sure. Sure, don't laugh. That one, don't go. It's you I want to be with, eh?
Sweet Dumebi.
Go, go to your house. Go to your house. Don't call me Mango. I'm not your Mango. Don't call me Mango. Go to your house. When Mr. Jim come, I'll discuss with Mr. Jim and then we'll call you.
Come.
Hey, no.
See, this time, eh? You are my queen. Eh? African queen. Sweet Mango.
Don't call me Mango. I'm not your Mango. I'm not your Mango. Go. When Mr. Jim come, I'll discuss with him and then I'll call you back. Go to your house.
Say thank you and to say that you are a gentleman. You took care of this lady and our baby without any attempt at violating her. You know, this speaks volume of your personality and I appreciate.
Thank you. Excuse me.
I'm not going with you. I'm marrying you.
You're not serious.
I found somebody who loves me as I am. Bush, bad English. You like me like that. And he's going to punish me with time.
Stop talking nonsense. Is it all the same thing that I promised to do?
You force yourself. He did not force himself. His own is natural. You like me the way I am. And you like to sleep with me like I am. And then you push me out to save yourself from my shame. You push us inside bus quarters. Do you remember? Me and my son, we eat sardine and bread. We see disgrace in your house. Now, we have a home. I'm going to stay here because he wants to pay my bride price. When my son grew up, if you want to carry him, come and carry him. But for now, Jim will be his father.
Yeah. And if you wish to contest that in a competent court of law, we will be very happy to fix you.
Oh, Mr. Jim, you're a gentleman and it has not come to this. Please don't do this.
Don't begin. It's not a decision, no. It's my decision. I like the way you love me. There's no use to hide it. You used to hide your own because you're ashamed of me. 2 weeks now, me and you are going to go to the village. You've got to pay my bride price.
Mm-hmm.
Don't worry. Very soon you find another girl. But if you find another girl, show her love. Show her love though. No matter what anybody is going to say, show her love.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah?
Look, you push it. Leave me alone. Leave me alone. I said I will get back to you. Look, look. You want to shoot me alone. That's right. Dumebi, I should have loved you without thinking of what fools say. Stupid man like me. I was too bothered with rubbish things that do not even matter. What is eating with my heart? What is speaking too much ground? I should have put in school myself. I was carried away by Kalyau. Okay, see me now and see Kalyau now. Another man has taken the movie out of my hand. I've lost the movie. Eh? I've lost the movie. I've lost everything. I've lost.
Well. Did you ever think that I was going to take your wife?
Did you ever think that I was going to leave you?
Well, Dumebi here actually begged me to help her to play the role of teaching you a lesson. A moral lesson about how to value what you have. Well, I'm sure that by now you've learned your lessons. And so I'd suggest that you pay her bride price as quickly as possible. Because there are so many men out there, indeed, plenty of them, waiting to have what you are neglecting.
Do maybe my ordinary girl.
so local and so simple, but I love her so. To me, my ordinary girl, ordinary girl, in an ordinary world. She's not a sophisticated lady, she no no big grammar. Some people say she did crazy, but she no no wetin she did do. To me, my ordinary girl, ordinary girl, in an ordinary world. She's not a sophisticated lady, she no no big grammar. She's so local and so simple, but I love her so.